Good morning, Pottsboro High School.
I'm Kaitlyn Lovell.
And I'm Aiden Anderson.
Today is Thursday, October 19th.
And this is your Cardinal Chronicle.
This Friday, our football boys have a game against Reigns at 7. The student section theme is pink out, so be sure to sport your best pink attire and support our football team.
Also this Friday, our volleyball girls are going up against Leonard to play them at 4:30, so be sure to give them all a big good luck.
We hope you guys are ready for some spooky fun. Haunted Halls is this Saturday. Keep bringing that candy to your classes while you still can.
Next Tuesday, volleyball has another game, this time against Blue Ridge at 5. Good luck, girls.
If you're looking forward to Boograms, then now is your time. Orders for Boograms are due next Tuesday for $3 and will be delivered to students at the end of October.
Juniors, if you're planning on taking the PSAT, don't forget that it is next Wednesday starting at 8 in the morning. Be ready.
If you're interested in joining any UIL events, Mrs. Wright is looking for people to sign up. If you have any questions regarding UIL, talk to Mrs. Wright. There will be more information coming.
Archery will begin after school on Mondays and Wednesdays from 6 to 8 in the gym. Come and go as you please starting next week. Next week is reserved strictly for returning archers though, but past that, it is open house for whenever you want to come.
FCCLM members, Mavs night is November 8th if you're interested in going. $40 either in cash or check needs to be turned into Ms. Dyer by Friday, October 20th. Your $40 colors the speaker series, game ticket, and $10 in Mavs cash. Be sure to talk to Ms. Dyers if you have questions.
Remember, cards, we don't have school on Monday. Enjoy the 3-day weekend.
Today, I'm meeting with Harley Carr and Kenley Lovell, two short individuals that face many challenges in their day-to-day life. Hopefully, we can meet with them, learn more, and discover new solutions to their problems.
Hi, I'm Kenley Lovell, and I am unwillingly 5'2".
I'm Harley Carr, and if I don't grow anymore, I'll be a legal dwarf. I'm 4'10".
Sometimes whenever I talk to people, it's just like, hey.
How are you doing today, Kenley?
Don't look down at me. I'm a human. I have feelings.
Growing up 4'10", it's affected me a lot, and I've never been able to reach the door frame, to slap it, to just get that joy going out of class.
Hey.
I'm Kenley.
Harley.
It's really nice to meet you.
Kenley and Harley agreed to a life-changing procedure. If all goes well, it will result in almost doubling their height.
This is a day to not live in infamy. This is a day to be celebrated, and I couldn't be more happy to have 6-foot legs.
What are we getting again?
You said you wanted squirt.
Okay, let's.
Oh, that's D8.
But even the most minimum tasks came with extreme hardship. For example, getting a soda from the vending machine.
So glad we didn't need that extra dollar. I think that's lost forever, actually.
It's too low to the ground.
Taste
like a grapefruit.
Can I try?
Yeah, what do you want?
That was really good.
Kenley, now that we're one person, I hate to tell you this, but you have to stretch for cross country with me.
I have to do that too.
Really reach my toes.
Come on, you need them anyway.
Now that we've worked out, I have to do my algebra homework.
Oh, okay.
So.
To my disappointment, the top half of our body was disproportionately more smart than the bottom half.
Oh my gosh, I don't know how to do this equation.
Did you drop it?
I dropped it.
Well, I can't even see where it went because I can't move my head.
Okay, it's over there. Just
over. Oh. I can't do this anymore. Okay.
Maybe it's good to be short.
I think you're right, Harley.
I think I am.
I miss my short body.
This is wonderful.
This is how it's supposed to be.
This is just grand.
Never again.
Never.
No.
This is a 1998 Toyota Tacoma, and we love this vehicle.
And we personally got permission to check out the interior.
Colin Furness is going to drive us around in this vehicle. Let's cut to that.
This is that exact same Tacoma, and let me tell you.
The interior.
I love this interior.
Love this interior.
You got beautiful moonroof here. We'll go ahead and open that up for you. While that's going, I'll show you. Lightning port, 3.0 USB here to charge your phone from the
all
bottom.
All real leather seats.
You got ventilated and heated seats here in the front.
On a 98 car, that's insane.
Insane that they had this. Massive moonroof.
Yeah, lots of space.
Back seats, lots of...
Plus the bed.
True. This is a 2021 Bronco Sport. I don't know why you would buy this car. The Sport Broncos, I think it's kind of tarnishing the name
tarnishing
of the Bronco.
The name.
I'd say don't buy this. Here's actually some statistics here.
So to summarize, just buy a Kia Soul.
Don't like this.
This is a Mustang, I don't like it.
Now here, if you pour some hot water, use like a, yeah.
They've been doing some modifications, you can really tell. I mean, they really put
is
that.
Is that a weight modification?
It's
or
a
aerodynamic.
Weight, it's actually a visual modification.
Oh, the 2020 Chevrolet Silverado. Comes with the Z71 package.
Love the color.
Installed on it.
They've
I do
the
like the color. That is probably my favorite thing about this truck. And once more, we did get in the interior.
Yeah, we asked the owner, I'm like, you gotta let me do a road test of this. I wanna see how it drives. And he said, sure, gave me the keys. We're gonna cut to that net.
This is that same Silverado. Once more, we're in the interior here. And honestly, I'm kind of disappointed.
A bit disappointed. The big spacious bed in the back.
How does it drive, Joe?
It kind of drives like it's... I mean, the upgrades, you can definitely tell. There's bigger tires.
I could
But it kind of drives like it's from the 90s,
I could see
opinion.
That. I mean, what modern
the interior,
car?
The interior right? is very low quality, very 90s.
Plasticky. You can see it's sun.
You know, if you're spending that much money to upgrade a truck and then buy a truck, you
I
know,
don't see the
at
point.
Least you get the big bed space
oh,
behind you.
Oh, you do get a camper as well. We didn't even know. Is that heated? I believe that is heated.
I believe it is heated, yes.
That's interesting. I
that's
actually,
interesting.
That's kind of fascinating to me that they would have a heated camper. You can tell they've had some work down here.
Tell they've had some work.
Slam on the brakes as hard as you can. 2006 Chevrolet 2500. And
we actually have an interview with the person.
We do actually have an interview.
He knows the person who owns this truck. So, Connor?
Give us your insight.
The person who owns this truck is Grayson Newberry.
Grayson, this is Grayson Newberry's truck.
What do you like about it?
To be completely honest with you, nothing. I've heard stories about how Grayson Newberry has broken down in the middle of a highway before.
Oh, that's not
those two.
But
very reliable, I guess.
Other than that, this truck really offers you nothing. I don't know what on earth happened to this bed. Something happened, and I really want to get to the bottom of it.
I love Grayson Newberry's truck. I think it's very nice. You know, it's well built, very durable. Should last them a long time.
Hey guys, it's time to sign up for UIL academic events again this year. So make sure to check out these posters and find an event you're interested in. Talk to Ms. Wright or Ms. K to find out more information. There will also be a student activities event conference this Saturday, October 21st, where you can learn more about your event. Make sure to talk to someone about that. Should be fun.
To put too fine a pine on it. Say I'm the only bee.